Thank you, Deputy Chairman, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak on appropriation bill. Bills together for consideration and return. I would say this is the huge legislative business. The discussion, including 79 grants and appropriations, it is a part of gross additional spending estimated 6.28 trillion after accounting for 2.15 trillion of savings and reallocation from ministries underutilized funds. If one looks into cash outgo, rupees 64,598 crores is for enhanced expenditure for fertilizer subsidy under Atmanirbhar Abhiyan. Against the background of ongoing farmers' agitation, it is not surprising that the union budget has not proposed any radical reforms of the existing fertilizer subsidy regime. In fact, the budget presented by Finance Minister, a backdrop of COVID pandemic. COVID has seriously impacted not only lives but livelihood across the world, and India has no exception. The House must agree that how Finance Minister grappled unprecedented situation is praiseworthy. So all kudos to Honorable Finance Minister. Our GDP growth is steadily decreased from 8.1% in last quarter of 2017-18 to 3.1% in last quarter of 2019-20. The Indian economy is expected to sink further 8% during 2021. But the positive aspect is that we have been able to bounce back in the third quarter of 2021. The only way a union government could support additional expenditure on healthcare and other essential expenditures aimed at job creation like MNREGA, free distribution of food grains, etc., was through borrowing an additional amount of 10.52 lakh crores. This has led to a historical high fiscal deficit of 9.5% against expected deficit of 6.8% of GDP 2021. To this extent, union government acted swiftly to avoid further damage to economy. So I congratulate the government, particularly Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman ji, for this. Keeping in tune with COVID demands, the budget earmarked an expenditure of 2.23 lakh crores in the coming year on health and well-being. This is 137% increase from last year. Although this includes expenditure on vaccination, including the grants by Finance Commission. Outlay on drinking water and sanitation of about 60,000 crores and 2,700 crores for nutrition and are most welcome. The appropriation bill includes defense services. The capital outlay for armed forces was increased by nearly 19%, with total outlay of 4.78 lakh crores. With our standoff with China, the government keeps it pursue strings loose for defense expenditure despite of pandemic. And sir, if you look into capital expenditure on road transport and highways, equally high and noteworthy of 1.80 lakh crores. Yeah. Sir, with all said and done, the areas of concern are lower provisioning of social sector schemes such as MNREGA. It has decreased to 1.1 lakh crores to 73,000 crores. 2.87 lakh crores is allocated to Jal Jeevan Mission over 6 years to give piped and safe drinking water to 2.8 lakh crores households in 2.8 lakh crores households. In Telangana, we have already had achieved more than 98% target by mobilizing resources of the state borrowing from financial institutes through our flagship program Mission Bhagirath by spending 30,000 crores under our dynamic leadership of our Honorable Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu. Mission Bhagirath has become role model to the country and inspiration for Jal Jeevan Mission. tax devolution states heavily impacted as there is reduction in revenue receipts of the union. Secondly, performing states have been penalized by 15th Finance Commission.
Please conclude now.
Yeah, I would be failing in my duties if I have not raised issues relating to my state, Telangana. There were a lot of expectations from Government of India would give a special package of 25,105 crores under various heads. It is expected that central will compensate state under Jal Jeevan Mission for completing Mission Bhagiratha. Releasing of amounts ₹1,350 crores each year, 450 for 2019-20, 2021 and 2022. Under the package of development of backward regions of the state mandated under Section 94 of 2 AP Reorganization Act, dues amounting to 817.61 crore rupees of 14th, just a moment, sir. On the whole, if all these policies announced are implemented earnestly, there is a hope of, that India will bounce back quickly from the havoc caused by COVID to economy. With these words, I support the proposal of Honorable Finance Minister and commend the bill to be returned. Thank you.